Welcome to a CareCollab update. This is Colmanara Masai Red, and the Orchid Saga is joining me today on an update. It's been a while since we had a look at Colmanara Masai Red on the first CareCollab for this orchid. Thank you, the Orchid Saga, for getting in touch with me because exciting news. Ha! We're gonna see blooms in this CareCollab and not on my plant, as you can see. The fun thing about these care collabs is that we grow the same orchid in different climates, in different setups, different environments, and all this diversity has orchids reacting in a different manner, also growth habit, when they bloom, etc. Now I'm here in southern Spain. We are in November. My temperatures have dropped drastically at night. I am now down to 11 degrees Celsius. Only for a week or so because of whatever polar whatchamacallit that is hovering over us. These low temperatures in November are quite unusual. This is, of course, Oncidium Alliance. They shouldn't be out when it gets that cold, and they shouldn't be out when it gets that cold, especially with my setup of Leca and self-watering, evaporative cooling, all that fun stuff, which is wonderful in the summer, keeps the orchid stress-free. But in the winter, it becomes a little bit more delicate, especially in my situation, because as you can see, this orchid is enormous. Huge structures, big leaves. And yeah, she doesn't fit into my grow space. So for the time being, I have her in this place here on a chair because I'm trying to protect the leaves from getting nasty, as you can see. Now, this would be an old leaf, but this happens quite quickly in my climate, especially on new growths, because I don't have humidity to speak of. And that is why I'm trying to protect her a little bit, keep her more in a shaded location. There is a breezeway, but I do have like a silver bush next to her and a fires to the other side of her. So I'm hoping that I can balance out the airflow and break strong winds, shredding my leaves or dehydrating the tips because of the lack of humidity in my climate. The airflow right now is perfect, but it can get much, much stronger. So as an update, what is happening right now is her location is not where she would be living for the rest of the winter. Once my temperatures drop below 10 degrees Celsius, she is gonna go into my south-facing blooming alley. It is a covered space like a portico, and there she will be in a corner where she will get some direct sun coming in through the trellising. That area is a few degrees warmer than if she were to stay out here where the breezeway is, because my winter temperatures at night will drop to a horrendous 5 degrees Celsius, and I'm dreading those nights, and so does this orchid. She does not like it, but she hangs in there because clearly she's still around. She's not the prettiest of specimens, but she definitely is a specimen. I have a few more years of her in this pot as long as she continues to grow her growth where she's growing them. I still have more space in the corner back here for another year's growth. I mean, look at the size of these pseudobulbs. Goodness me. So yeah, this growth happened to decide to grow right in between two pseudobulbs. So I'm quite pleased. That gives me a little bit more time. There's another growth back here that is also growing towards like the center of the outer edge. That's gonna buy me some time around the back there. And there's a growth right here. This one, there we go. This growth is also tucked up to the edge. We're gonna have to wait and see what that does with its next growth, but I'm hoping to not have to do anything with this pot for a considerable amount of time. And that is why I put her in a little bit of an oversized pot, because she is huge. I got her when she was something where I thought I can manage her, and here we are. Poor thing has to live outside. Still, she acclimated, she knows what she's in for, and I'm doing my best to protect her in that portico on the south-facing blooming alley. As you can see, I do not have any spikes growing yet. Mine normally will bloom around February, March, and it's always a nail biter with the fact that, oh, I hope those spikes will hold on because they are developing through the coldest month of the winter, January, February. So I'm always a little bit concerned if my spikes develop. But in the last 2 years, she managed to continue with the spikes despite the cold temperatures. And that just goes to show how this orchid can adapt to several different conditions. And if you have a temperate climate where you don't get down to freezing, then this one can actually live outside. The proof is in the pudding. It shares its pot with a resident fern. I had nothing to do with this fern joining it, but for the time being, it can stay. Every once in a while, I'll trim the leaves back and then it looks clean again, but it is so well established in there. They live together in harmony. Right now I'm fertilizing at 300 parts per million because yes, it is getting a little bit cooler. She is not growing as fast anymore, but because there are so many structures, I am still giving her 300 parts per million. And then I'm flushing her once a week. A full bucket of fresh RO water goes through the pot, even if she hasn't absorbed the entire reservoir of fertilizer. I don't want anything to go nasty over the winter in that pot. So once a week, a flush, and then I fill it up again with 300 parts per million. And that is my winter care coming up until such a time that she will bloom. So I really want to say thank you once again to the Orchid Saga. I have the link to his video in the description below, because I am going to be really, really excited to see Colmanara Masai Red blooms this time of year. Different growing environments, different setups, different climates. This is going to be a good one because there is a massive difference to what my Colmanara is doing this time of year as opposed to the Orchid Saga. Hope you found this interesting quick update. I appreciate your time. Wishing you a beautiful, beautiful day, but again, on one condition. Please stay safe and take care. Bye.